స్తబతుగున్న రేండ్రే, స్తబతుగున్న తాబూతు శల్లంగ వర్ణమగ నామగమా ఇల్లి మన కలగున మేమత కత్తలవుమాన రేడియో ఫీజ్ కమసినికు ఫేస్బుక్ సోల్స్ టు జీసస్ రోతలాండ్ కుసరవ డెలి కంపస్ ఎన్ఎంఐ టీవీ. Ni sambulu mina kana turanga na marama dharu nungu nelewa ene mataka ni sigende ndai wa kambule tukani wikenda na leo ibiti ndo warungu tukumai na katala umana Radio Fiji One wikenda kenda ndo usara batuko na Souls to Jesus campus ini kwa wikenda ndo usara TV Daily Campus so wa kambule tukani ene pato matata mga warungu kina se usara sara kina ene mataka ni sigende kwa wa kambule tukumai wikenda na leo ibiti ni satu na biasa iburubure so gito la wadadaka la wangande la wabuli wikenda tanga sa leo nibulo tunde itu na bibono nda tukina nibulo binaka samoa mai tonga mai banu watu mai niwe mai rara tonga mai natu masela natu ka natu natu Hawaii kapatala kina wikenda na natu kiri mai nauru mai dake Guam kautu so mai Solomoni banu watu watala kina wikenda kenda warutu mai New Caledonia. Sini mulai dah mina nonda neighbours lilevu, New Zealand di bawah Australia, aku sabar kamu boleh tukar ni, kebawa barang tu main mata kan isi ni kuah. Kamu boleh tu ya Europe, nak tukar loe lama, bata lagi na, nak boleh lebih ke Amerika. Mata tu buka isi, kau barang tu main mata kan isi ni kuah. Ni mami ngono eviti, saya nak ngono dah mengamai na nombor ni benua, aku sabar kamu boleh tukar ni. Kita bagi kemuni handun dua sara, enak kau komandi ada cisu. Ena sebe na nyukwa. Tuna British Army, lagona bitango maki, obisa sotia, ena toka loe loma. Sebikenda ndorubo u, nibiti, lagu tuba angito. Ena bimunu wa dhamanga, waka Europe, watala akina, Japani, ena bunu waka Asia, se wikenda angito boli tunga Australia ke New Zealand. Wikenda angito boli mai Amerika, usaba kambule tugani, ena kukomani ya dechisu, ena mataka nisi nikwa. Kati wikenda ni voltambu, ni tomana tiko chisu na vuna umena uli vanua. Wase lima madhi, wase lima tikine tiniga vitu, kene tikine tiniga walu. Ndo kakwe ni waka sama ni usalako maeme upakotia na vuna. Se non repaka mbuli na profita. Usasini lako maeme upakotia, mi upaka dhoranga. Ni usakaya waka indi na wike mdou, enesenga ni takali manda, kolo malange kiburubura. Ia enesenga ni takali. Maine vuna u indua, na mata ni wala lilai sendua na tikina lilai sara ena yado manda kedenga turanga kene marama viwa kani siku minanga nikua nona lago magu chisu me meipagandita na kake de yado tuli volta mu makawa gure kandi na todoko kemba le tuza kena wama lai roma na dindibara gure ni ipagata na reitaya lalonga ni karo ni zakama na kaloki ni nondambula ena siku minanga nikua kabi kenda ni volta mu na zaka zaka mana liwe zakama na kaloku. Sengwa lenga, viva kurumbuita kini kaza kama kalu. Sengwa lenga, nona vi maruru ina kalu, kibi ira non tamata. Ena, nivolo tambu, kabola itu ena tora, sena pinte tuku. Iba kumatata kitu vike enda na kali uweza kama kalu. Sake kabi kenda kuchisu ninyo, nivuna utiko. Ena, sena sarangani ndua na tikina lila ena kaulebi. Na kangori ndina kethitu. Kembali turangini marama ika kukwaya. Aula ngame mubu kaithora. Kembali kwa mibu kaithora, tukuna na kaitha kama tukuna kalu. Eni volta mmakawa. Kakethera tukuna profita. Kalilemu na kalalai. Ngori na kakethe. Kaibi kenda ni volta mbu. Okwa ni mibu kaithora. Tukuna solika. Okwa mibu kaithora na solika. E mibu nutaka na solika. Na loloma. Okwa mibu kaithora na loloma. Na kaira ndodha kama maina farisi kirebuni bola. Mibu katobula ikino na mbula. Sianga. Okwa etosweza kitali kina ndona levolo. Nana bulan ni beidati, nana bulan ni dawai lewa. Okey, tosa tak kita lagi nanti level. Nono baga tak buli tak. Nikah itu okey. Aku sih lama memuai baga dia. Aku laku serang memuai baga dora. Naka era ini donu biar faris kira buni bola. Okey, angai baga dala. Naka endonu biar entamata. Okey, angai baga dala. Mendina tu mengakina. Nalo lama lebu ni kalu. Okey, mematata matana tak serang. Nalo lama lebu ni kalu. Kambula taki baga lilai. Ena nona tosu tu na Israeli ena ngono kwa nona vita ngomaki ema ipagari taka bakele lai nona vima roi ema ipagari taka ukwa nona zaka zaka mana ema ipagari taka ukwa ena sikimina ni kwa tunoka duko seri nenu mani ulo kumai mo bogotia le bune tal tal le bune sum sum golotu era durni kwa era sakatu ne buna ngo ne buno ani bolu volta mo kawa ne buno ngo ne buno ani volta mo sian ci sue ka ngo usi na mai mo mai bogotia olo sara mo bogadora ke male ne volta mo bo e matana takinga kina na kalo kambula e ne volta mo kawa haleluya ke male na rubanga yo na be ka ngo si wina ni kwa ke ndaru sa wili talanga e na saka saka mana e na saka saka yado ni nonda rukalo e ni sigi mina ni kwa ka ko ni ko muze ka ko ni ko suka muri ka ko ni ko elo lelai ni garaba na kalo le bugo mbalaba o ko na nona vine kata me dorminaka e lelai na nonda rubina kata me dorminaka o na bita tali dor ke ni bibi uroro e lebu za ke na nona vine kata tisu me dorminaka ka lelai na nonda rubina kata o ke dar me dorminaka ya na nona loloma na kalo loloma ba kai kuritaki loloma sanga ni alani na loloma sanga ni bagaya la ya na loloma ni kalu nge loloma ku tisu nge me matana taki bekena me rao rao ki na nuna rukila ni kenda rusia mo bawa na kalu kenda ruwili boga lubi ni kalu ni nda ruwia bawa mo ti tisu nga me nonda ru turanga me nonda ru bambula ka bekena volta musa alesi me nda ruwiazo me nda ru lubi ni kalu na we kangu ni matanga ni sige ni ndai na numa tuku ni kwa ni kusa soli mbula me tisu ni kusa wili tiko monona lube na kalu ene mataka ni sige ni ndai chobo na ni mami kalu vina wale muni pakan dita ki biki mami ni ki mami lube muni na nraki ni mbula ni tabo tu ni tao ki mami kila tuko ni ki mami lube muni na mrabu na buwana lenga kaki mami sotaba ki mami kila tuko ni ki mami sa lube muni li uta ki ki mami ene lako lako mbula nrende na mbula mbole mbole do kairu kobi nga kine za muni ki mami zubo kamasu edha muni chisu na ibo kambula amen. O kende kende anta matalotu kende biya reida na kailaka raita uva kwa mechisu
Rani angona edani kena kudubi kena rani kena tima
Chona ngona ekoto mani duindu iba na lotu sa tiko roba te kena lotu burumai Na ibo katangi kena kena raka tiko na tuisi ena lama niwa lotu
Karuna Fears every Wednesday at 6 PM only on my TV.
Greetings in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's so wonderful to be here again.
Amen.
In the studio here in Turek in Suva to greet you in the matchless, wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And first of all, we do apologize for the 10 to 15 minutes delay due to a blackout here in Turek area, in Suva area. But anyway, greetings from the studio here in Turek in Suva. Our God is a can-do God. So we take this time to say hello to those of you that are at home, in your workplace, in your vehicle, and you are watching this program, Miracles, the miracles of God in our life, which
Amen.
Is the kingdom economics that we'll talk about during this God of Our Nation program. Against all odds, against things that we are facing, against pandemics or natural disaster, our God is a can-do God. So we take this time to greet you once again in the mighty, matchless name of our Lord Jesus Christ. To those in Lau, to those in Vanualevu, Raramba, and to those in Vitilevu across our nation, we take this time to greet you
Amen.
In the matchless, wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. To the church, NCF, we greet you. We know that you are logging from home in our family worship time. And we believe that you are ready with the Holy Communion
yes.
as we normally program ourselves, God of Our Nation program. Eh? And also to all denominations that you are tuning in from home, Lotu Daba, Lewen, and Matagan Nisigandai, Sabe Kinda Bagetugan, Vikandan Lotu Esle, Vitikirutuma, Vikandan Lotu Kavitu, Vikandan Ecclesia, Vikandan Gospel, Baptist, Makatanagina Pentecostal. We take this time to welcome you all in the mighty and matchless name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And again, today, God of Our Nation will talk about the blessings and the provision in connection with your heart.
Amen.
And we have have some few worship centers. Hallelujah.
We came to a new worship center. This is for New Methodist for the previous months. That's January,
April.
Yes.
And April.
So quite a good artwork. Yeah. And the reward for those zones who have gone out of their way to create these new worship centers. And also we would like to acknowledge these new worship centers, even though now you are worshiping in as family. So we have the Jephthah Worship Center and the Mount Sinai. We have the God's Divine Worship Center. That's for the Natambua Zone, for the two worship centers from Natambua Zone. Thank you, Talanga Sisimi and Auntie Francis. The Jephthah Worship Center is from the Nandera Zone. And also for, for the month of March, we have Mount Carmel. And that's from the Wainimbuku Zone. Thank you. And April, there's quite a few. We have the Provider Worship Center from Vitongo, Bulavinaka, Nakorme Vitongo. We have Divine Heights Worship Center from Tavo Votukola. And also we have Gideon Worship Center and Jireh. For Votu Olevu, we have two worship centers. One is Jireh, the other one is another, God's Divine Heights from Votu Olevu Zone. And also for Gideon, we have Nosori Zone. So to those of those new worship centers and all the senior pastors that belong to the zone that have brought upon this new extension of our kingdom, new members coming in, and also new worship centers established. We take this time to say thank you. And also to make a mention to those of you that are actually logging in from home on the virtual program, I believe it's going to be a new norm again. Nothing new, because we've been through, and it's like a replay of what we have done before. Today it's a bit more better because you're actually worshiping God with your family. You're sitting with your family. You're sitting right at home. Before we had that 20 allocation that had the worship center. So you're worshiping in, as a worship center. But today it's a family. So for us would be a really great start to what we are facing right now, because the family, when they're together, it's very hard for anything to come before us. Not only that, all strong families put together, that's a workforce to be reckoned with. And we take this time to also acknowledge those of you that are logging in outside Fiji, New Zealand. I believe you people have your own program. You had your regional coordinates meeting yesterday. And Australia, you also have your program. Thank you to the Sukani couple with the program posted yesterday for all. For Sydney, inclusive of Brisbane and Gold Coast, as well as the Griffiths. So we stand today to acknowledge all. And also to Europe, I know it's your evening back on Saturday, and Germany, not forgetting Northern Ireland and Scotland for the Naisua family. And in Manila, we have Talanga Stiko, and also the virtual zone all over the world, wherever you are, American Samoa, yeah. Marshall Islands, the Cook Islands, all over, that you belong to the virtual zone. And thank you, SB Phil, as well as Associate Senior Pastor Ngalovi. Thank you for all the efforts made to bring about the healthiness of that. Yeah. And not only that, we have the seasonal workers right all the way in Napier. Usually have your program every Sunday evening, and we take this time also to acknowledge all those people that are logging in and being part of this program. Mm. And just before this program, we were actually talking about those who always take the time to come here to my TV to give your seed. Seed is in terms of tithe, of offering, and also just general seeding, because you felt you've been blessed by the word of God shared through this studio from all denominations that are coming here to share with Fiji. And not only that, wherever our Facebook accessible to all over the world. And most of you, or some of you, counting the numbers, there's about 18. 18 in terms of families and individuals are walking up to my TV to give that envelope. It's the envelope of tithe and offering, maybe as little as $10, and some as $5, and right up to $1,000 or $2,000, depending on the giving. And we've had some who want to be remaining anonymous, that you have done a bank transfer straight to the TV ministry account. We also stand today to say thank you for that heart to sin. Thank you for that commitment, and thank you for the sacrifice that you have heard the word of God, and you thought and you believe that it can work in your life. And by doing that, you act beyond and being part of that giving that help this ministry also help my TV to be able to continue to air the programs back to you. So today, as we come towards our Holy Communion, towards the end of the program, we will also remember you. And Gasele, we will also pray for all of you that have taken the time to bring your envelope right up here to my TV in Turek, in Suva.
I also take this time to thank the Nwanturangana TV Bitong for the wonderful evangelism that was happening in your village.
Last week, we take this time to say,
Binaka, not only in your village in Bitongo, but also in Matawa. Talano Assassin and Naviango, Saru, and we take this time to say Binakabalebu for the good heart. And we were blessed being there last week from Wednesday right up to Friday. We take this time as ministry leader on behalf of New Methodist Christian Fellowship to say Binakabalebu. And again, on Sunday, we have a wonderful gathering in the Rarapaka Festival Ground in Lotoka. Hallelujah. Binakabalebu. And we also take this time to advise all those villages that we are already conduct Talano session. Remember, every Wednesday at 6 o'clock, the current affairs with Collier. It's a wonderful program on My TV. It's a My TV program. So 6 o'clock every Wednesday, 6 p.m. Current affairs. That is the time that you can listen to the Talano session that enlighten our walk with God.
Hallelujah. Mm. And also an acknowledgement to the feedback that we have received from the Tuisawana. Yeah. I thank you to Sawana family in advising this morning that all our Iraq soldiers were affected with the COVID.
Praise the Lord.
They went through all the processes of being tested negative, and all of them are all normal back at work. So to all the families out there and having your dads back out there in the field in Iraq, they are all well and they're all back at work. So
praise
thank you for that feedback, Auntie Amy and Brother Samu, for, you know, it's just so awesome just to see and hear and read on the miracles that God, only God can do.
And if it happens there in Iraq, it will also happen here. In Fiji. Whatever we are facing in Fiji at the moment, in Cunningham or in Motoriki and also in Lotoka, God can do it.
Amen.
He has done it before, he can do it again. Because he is a God.
Hallelujah.
Can do God.
And I believe, as a believer, we must come in support of our nation and also pray for the 22 or for the number that we have in hand announced by the permanent secretary for the Ministry of Health on those that have been affected. They are families. They have their families affected and they are relatives out there in support of whatever is going, you know, they're going through. It can be a very difficult moment of their life. So I believe that we must remember them and support them in prayers, even though the reporting are going every day on how they're doing the media release and the media announcement every afternoon. We, as a believer, we must support our nation, not only in following the rules, but in praying as a child of God to pray and support the families that have been affected.
These are elements of healing that even the world cannot understand. Science cannot understand. And that is the healing from God. He's Jehovah Rapha, the healer.
Hallelujah.
If we can heal the 92 soldiers in Iraq, he can also heal the 20 case that we have here in Fiji. And we do believe that. You know, this program is not only here because of what we are going through. It's now 1 year of this program, God of our nation. That means God's hand will be always on our nation, and God will help our leaders, whether in the Vanua, in the government, in churches, and our God will be with those medical staff, the ministry, the minister of health, and also the permanent secretary of health, and all the doctors, all the nurses, and all the workers, including the military and the police, those that are in the front line.
Amen.
Because God can do it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He has done it so many times in the Bible, and he can do it again today. And maybe next week we'll be standing here and we'll testify
what God can do.
We have another 8 days to go of the 14 days. We have another 8 or 9 days to go, and we believe that God will do it because he's already done it. He's a God of yesterday, he's a God of today, and he's a God of tomorrow.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, New Methodist, if you're logging in today, just a reminder, you need to download that Fiji Care app on your phone, one and first. And secondly, you need to register, getting yourself ready for your jab or your vaccination. And stay home, stay safe. Take this moment to spend more family time with your family. Appreciate your children. They are at home, away from school, and create programs for them to stay home. And just watch over your family and have your family prayer time. And also decide on a day that you have to fast. And fast for our nation, fast for your family, and fast for God's miraculous breakthrough, because it can happen as we come together. Hallelujah. As believers. So back to the program today. We actually talked about the kingdom economics and against all odds. So the kingdom economics. Kingdom economics is always the opposite of the secular world economics. In the secular world, you save, you have your money piling up, you know you're putting your money there, or you know, you channel your money to the things you know you're going to gain out of it. In the kingdom economics, the first priority, you take your tithe and you put it aside. Indirectly, you're telling God, I acknowledge you as my source, and this is what I stand on, the promises of your word, because your word says so, that I need to give a tithe of what I receive, or tithe of what I get or I can achieve. So you set it aside. So you can be a farmer with a plantation, or you can be a lady at home like me, doing your cooking at home. You can be a fisherman. You can be any other person. It's not like only those who go to work and get financial as a reward or as a salary that they give tithe. No, it's for every believer and for every individual. And whatever that you do or get, a tenth of that you must give to your God. So as you honor God with that, then the 90%
Because tithe is all about obedience.
Yes.
It's not about the money. It's not about all this. Yeah. It's about obeying that God will do it. Yeah. When you follow, the obedience is very, very important as we walk with God. And the obedience opens those windows of
heaven. Hallelujah.
And as we stand here, and some people that they are going through hard times of this life, we just need to obey. We just need to be obedient in whatever the word is telling us today. And with that word, because the Bible says man does not live on bread alone.
Hallelujah.
But every word that proceeded from God's mouth.
Amen.
And when we obey, we are telling God,
Hallelujah.
You are our source.
Yes.
Our source is from you. God can use other resources, but he is the source. All our source comes from God, whether we work in the government or any organization or any company, or maybe just staying in the village, or we are farmer, we are fishermen. But our source, hallelujah, where we go to for our resources, God supply the source to
hallelujah.
The resources.
Yes.
We receive from the resources, but God is the source. Hallelujah. And when we obey his word, trusting in him, the Bible says, seek him first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added. That is another form of obedience.
Hallelujah.
We just need to seek God. We need to surrender our life to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And when we believe in the kingdom economics, we are not worried about what's happening.
Hallelujah. Yes, I believe that. Yeah.
We are not worried about what's happening around us. When the Israelites were told to go to Canaan, I mean, you talking about more than 2 million people. Mm. Hallelujah. That means it's the population of Fiji times two. And when God said, you go to Canaan, I mean, you look at the map from Egypt to Canaan, there's a desert, the Sinai desert. I mean, who will survive in those,
Hallelujah.
In the heat and the sun, and no supermarket, no footwear shop, and no market.
Clothing shop.
Nothing there.
And no restaurants.
Because God says so.
Hallelujah.
His word will provide. Because he says so, go to the other side. Whatever happens between now and the other side, God is the source.
Amen.
When Jesus said in Mark chapter 4, let us go to the other side. Nobody knew of the cyclone or of the pandemic. Nobody knows of in the middle of the night, in the middle of the lake, then the
Amen.
Storm will come.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Nobody knows that. But because he said, let us go to the other side. The word has everything. The word of God has everything.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So when we're going through this time, and there are some people that they maybe they are looking for food on the table, the clothes on their back, and a roof over their head.
Amen.
It's immaterial when you walk in the kingdom economics.
Hallelujah.
Our problem is to focus on the word of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When we trust in God, when we focus on the word of God, God will meet us wherever we face with the pandemic, whatever we face with the cyclone, natural
Hallelujah.
Disaster.
Yeah.
Of any kind. We will meet that because God is walking with us. He is our provider.
Hallelujah. So when you're working, the word tithe you remember, you know. And when you're not working, the word tithe is not only for those who work. And secondly, as you give, because the kingdom economics is a totally opposite, like what I said earlier, totally opposite of what the world think and how the world system works. And when you do your tithe, when you do your giving in whatever form, you will have your desires. Say you want a car or you want to renovate your home. Or there are certain things that will bring about cost and it has a cost to it. Or maybe it's a supply of your groceries right throughout the month for your family or your children's studies. There are a lot of things that have a dollar sign attached to it. And then you will have the opportunity to sit beyond. For New Methodists, what we've been teaching them, they are called the activators, meaning if I'm actually praying for certain things, I'm not just going to be giving my tithe to be the one that brings that to pass. My tithe, as soon as I give, or when I give, or when you do your tithe, like in terms of plantation, like when Castile was sharing, or fishermen, you take some of those fish and take it to your Waka Tower in the Koro, village, yeah. Or Tala Tala, or anybody who is a representative of God, wherever you are in your community, as you honor them with whatever tithe that you have, either from your Bella plantation, or your sewing for us, lady, or for our cooking at home, whatever that we give, that calls back, or it sort of administer your day-to-day living. So yeah. As soon as you give your tithe, it becomes God's, which means it's there to look after the administration of the things of his kingdom. He automatically looks after your administration, meaning for those of us that live in the urban area, it's the light, it's the electricity being paid, the telephone bills, the food supply every day. All those things are done administratively because you have given your tithe. And on the other note, on the activator is when you decide, say you're wanting a house or you're wanting a car or you're wanting education for your children or renovate your house, anything that has a price tag, then you name it. I've been sharing with my grandchildren at home, they're listening to me today, and I always tell them, no, you write your tithe and you write your activator, write your list, your exam results, or your family, or anything. So you name it, and then you are actually having that with God. And for those of us who do visitation, and we go and we share the word of God, or we give our tracts, or we go and help a full family, or you know that there is a family has got elderlies in it, and then they hardly have any able being to clean up the house. And cleaning up the home of that couple or the home of those elderly family, that's your tithe and that's your activator. You're actually activating. You are seeding something to impact his kingdom, and you are naming it to the things that you desire. And no, don't ever limit yourself for you to say, no, I'm not working. I'm not getting any salary, so I cannot really go there. Or I cannot achieve a car, or I cannot buy a house because I don't have any financial money coming in my way, or I don't have a work or salary that I receive at the end of the week, month, or fortnightly. No, it's never about money. It's about you. There's no limit to what you can achieve. There's no limit to what you can be. It's all up to you. Like what Gasile was saying, it's the power of his word. You need to believe in his word, and then you look at him as your source. You look at God as your source. You don't look at your company as your source. You don't look at your church as your source. You don't look at your family as your source. You look at God as your source. Yeah, good enough. If you say that you're working and you're working for a certain company, say for my TV, people who are working for my TV, yeah, they get paid. Some of them weekly and some of them fortnightly. Yes, they get the pay. But if you're working for my TV, you shouldn't look at my TV as your source. You should look at God as your source. Because when you look at God, you're not limited by the salary scale you're sitting on. You're not limited by the amount of money that you receive in your pay. You're not limited by that. Because you know God is your source. Hallelujah. Your list can go right up to achieving things that is not, you know, together with your pay. Like what I said, the kingdom economics is a little bit crazy.
Hallelujah.
You know, because you have that element of faith.
Yeah.
The faith is what takes you there, like for you to believe. Like, no, it can happen. It will happen. So don't just look at your pay and look at the resources that you have. Don't look at where you are. No, you believe in God. And just by activating and just by giving those tithes and just by acknowledging God in the things that you do, you'll be amazed on how God will use other people and situations in your life that you never even plan, not even budget or project, and it's going to happen without you spending any money on it. And that is the condition of your heart. heart and the commitment of your hand. Just by desiring to serve him and to let go of the evil ways and to walk away from the things of your life, which you know is pulling you back and stopping and being a stumbling block for God to provide into your life. Today is the day. So kingdom economics, like what I say, it's a little bit crazier because you need to know God and have faith for you to really live in the kingdom economics.
You are trusting in God. You are trusting something that you cannot see. And that's why people, it's difficult for them to believe in what they don't see.
That it can happen.
And that's why faith is the substance of things hoped for.
And the elements of things not seen.
Yeah, so when we believe in God, we are believing. It's not the tithe or giving. It's not only money. It's not. It's the thing that God bless you with, your talent, your gift. Some people, they are good accountants. They are good doctors. And that's why a lot of doctors, a lot of pilots, a lot of engineers, they put their talent, their gift aside. And they work in their churches, in the ministry, in NGOs. And those are the giving.
Amen.
And even if a fisherman, you know, the first thing that you do, you give to Ratu and you give to Taltala. Those are what we call the tithe express in another way. Some people, Amen. They just use their time. They don't have anything but their time. They go and clean up. They go and pray.
Yes.
You know, 24 hours. And you can put aside 2 hours, about 2 hours and 20 minutes. That's your tithe for a day.
Amen.
And you pray in the morning. You pray in the evening. And you divide how many minutes in the daytime. Those are all equal in the eyes of God.
Amen.
In God, there is no good job.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is no good job. There is no bad job. You know, a CEO and a cleaner, according to God, it's the same.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. One penny is the salary of everybody. Whether you are a lay preacher, whether you are reverend, or you are bishop, or you are ngaselebu, or only you are choir master, or maybe you just look after the vehicle in the car park. According to God, it's only one penny. Hallelujah. Because nothing about good job, nothing about bad job, nothing about good job and lower job. No, to God, it's a gift. Hallelujah.
Yeah. And he's looking at the heart.
And he's looking because everything he look at the heart. And when you believe in God, the intention of believing in God comes from your heart. And that's why the heart is very important. Hallelujah. I was talking this morning on the heart of the matter is your heart.
Because Hallelujah.
God is looking at our heart. Whether we're giving our tithe, we're giving our activator,
time,
or whatever, the time, the fish, the belly, or the coconut, or whatever we're giving. He's looking at our heart.
Yes.
The giving must based on three things. Number one, righteousness. Number two, mercy. And number three, it's your faith in God. You trust in God. That you know that God will do it. And whatever pandemic we're facing right now,
Amen.
Some people, and they were saying, oh, both of us work in the hotel. Now we are not working. But believe in God because
Hallelujah.
Your source is not the hotel. Your source
is God.
Is God.
Oh, Hallelujah.
And that's why when they stop the border, when they stop the tourism, those that have their source as their work, they stop too. They don't know where to turn to. But for those that they trust in God and believe in God, regardless, they close this side, God will open
Hallelujah.
Other doors
yes.
because he is the door. He can move around the door because he is the door.
Yeah.
And most of the time, the world today, they are full of worries and
Hallelujah.
Upset and anxiety.
Yes.
There are people in the news today, wherever they focus on, they just focus on people. They are trying to come into term of what's going on. No, this is the time to turn to God.
Hallelujah.
If my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray, if my people, if.
Hallelujah.
If you turn away from your wicked ways and you're humble and you turn to God and pray, the Bible says, I will hear from heaven. I'll forgive your sins and I will heal your land.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Because three things, we are one of those things right now that are stopping a lot of work and money flowing right now, which is when I send pandemic sickness amongst my people.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So don't worry. It's already in the Word of God. When you want to go through what we are facing right now, go back to the Word of God because He already said it. God already said it. Hallelujah. If I close heaven for rain not to fall, if I send locusts to eat up your crops, and if I send sickness among my people, Amen. And he said, my people who are called by my name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. For those of you Christians that you are listening, watching this morning, you have the key to open heaven again. Hallelujah. We can open the borders and start with the bubble and blue lane. If my people who are called by my name, humble themselves and pray, turn away from their wicked ways and seek my face. The Bible says, I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sin, I will heal their land. And my eyes will be open and watchful, and my ears will be attentive, and my heart will remain according to the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So don't worry, my friend. This thing happened before.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I remember about 100 years ago in 1912, about 1912 or 1914, Hallelujah. The Bible says, when I close heaven, when Amen. I send locusts, when I send sickness, my people who are called by my name.
Hallelujah.
We've been through this. The world been through this. Remember, there is a living God. There is a
Hallelujah.
Living God.
Yeah.
And his word is alive. How can we get this living God into our day-to-day operation? His word. We've been sharing, and we are blessed with my TV. Every day, 5 to 6, daily compass. Every day, 8 to 9, power in the word. So we are blessed, my friend, this morning, that the word of God can bring the things that are not seen need to be visible.
Hallelujah.
Because it is the word of God.
Yes.
He said it. I will be with you. If you go through waters, hallelujah.
He will be with you.
He will be with you. If you go through flame, he will be with
you.
He
will never touch
you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God is a God that not a man to lie, nor a son of man
yes.
to change his mind. So when you have a heart, it calls those blessings, regardless of what you're going through, regardless of
Amen.
The situation that you've been through. You have a good heart, it calls the blessing, because the blessing attached to a good heart. That's
Hallelujah.
Why Jesus was saying in the mountain of Beatitudes,
Blessed
are the pure
in
heart,
for they shall,
for they
see,
shall
God.
See God. You want to see God? Hallelujah.
Your heart has to be clear.
Your heart has
okay,
to
back
be
to
clear.
The heart. You may be listening in today with your family. You know, when this thing happened, your heart automatically turns, saying to yourself, again, what's going to happen? And some of the companies may not be allowed to open because of this new restriction.
Yes.
And then you lose your job or you're being told, okay, we'll wait until it becomes normal again. You know, just as we are getting back slowly to normalcy, and then we get strike with this thing again. The tendency to be bitter and to have a bad heart, it's very rife. It's there. Totolo sara na rani da totolo ni alanda. Balati ni bakenda rarota kani dona ka esanda vi na kada ki mai gayado talibi kenda na kaya
dogo.
Na ni alanda menda garuna. Balati ki bakai senga ko na yalo ya ko rani da kada kati kenda na turanga. Your heart has to be in the right condition for God to bless you or for God to work with you or to work around you and to work using you, not only for your family, not only for your community, not only for your village, but also for your nation. So Nambimbi Nyalanda, it's very important, the condition of our heart. But let us say we can do wrong to communicate wherever you are. And we can go to the house, 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 we can go to the house. You know, like it takes us back out of normalcy. Before, because the children is on school break. You know, they can up and go, they can do whatever they want to do. So they are, you know, in extra fact, out of your hands every now and then. But now, no, you are caught up with them and you will continue to see them. And when there is a lot of them, there is another handling. So, you know, your mind begins to work tricks on you and to tell you, if not for this thing, if not for this COVID, if not for this attack again, it could have been normal. And we cannot control the bitterness of our heart as and when that happened. Look, you cannot afford that. You need to let go. And so we can take a in the Rarotakana with Tinda, the Rarotakana Luvenda. You know, certain things, you look at them and it's not the way that you want things to happen. And without seeing it out, it becomes harbored in your heart. And those little things, they count when you come to the presence of God. Ningona ke tawo kina nelomo e tawo talanga na lingani kaloviko ningona tawo kina nelomo na kaya viti mobility ko maleti sasa iko na sinrani control tak maleti nelomo ningona zaki niko na sinrani ka chuma ko nelomo. No, don't have a bad heart. Get out of my life. No, you can't, because you that's you. So the only thing that can correct you, the only thing that can better that heart condition is the word of God. So you need to memorize the word of God. You need to speak the word of God over that heart, because the word of God is so powerful. powerful. And the word of God is your only assurance to make you break through in every situation of your life. So we can you can be sitting together as a family, you can be listening from your car, yeah. Or you can be standing anywhere else, right in the corner, you know, just on yourself, looking through that phone. If life has been so unfair to you until today, minus the COVID, if life, you say to yourself, nothing good seems to be happening to my life, whatever that you're going through, check, I will need you to stand still and just check your heart.
Check your heart.
Just clear your heart before God, yeah. And allow him to take you through. Allow him to, you know, to restore everything that you have lost. Some of us, we've lost our family, we've lost, yeah. Our husbands, lost our children, we lost our jobs. A lot of us are sitting, you know, in that situation. Today, don't count your loss, because it will make you bitter and it will make you sad and feeling depressed.
Hallelujah.
No, don't. Because there's nothing you can do or how hard or strong you're going to think about all those things that can restore. No. You stand up and say to yourself, I'm going to go clean before God. I'm going to serve him.
Yeah.
I'm going to allocate a time that I'm going to pray to him. I'm going to start giving my tithe. I'm going to walk straight before him. And I'm going to stand before my God and ask my God, Lord, I stand before you. Restore everything that I've lost.
Praise
restore
God.
My spouse. Restore my children. Restore my finances. Restore my wealth. Restore my good health. Mm. You have the right as a child,
yes.
Of God.
Yeah.
Look, you tell the devil enough. Tell the devil enough. Tell the devil to stop stealing your resources, to stop stealing the good life, stop stealing your good health, stop stealing the joy of your family. You're supposed to enjoy your family. You're supposed to enjoy your children. You're supposed to enjoy your life. And don't allow the devil to continue to steal. So you stand up today and you tell yourself, whatever that I'm going through, I'm going to walk straight with my God.
Yeah.
I'm going to make this a few decisions. I'm going to tweak my life. And I know that my mind can be positive because I'm thinking of my God. All the negative elements, you need to let go of it right now. Yes, you can look, you can read whatever, because you belong to the social media. You read about somebody talking about you, running you down, telling you off. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, the heart, you know, it can raise up. It can affect you badly. Look, you stand still. You read again and read again and say to yourself, no, I'm not going to be affected by this thing because I'm not this low. I'm greater than this because my God is the greatest God.
Hallelujah.
So rise above it, whatever that they throw at your face, whatever negativity they throw at you, don't ever allow that to define you. Don't ever allow that to take you down. You rise up and you say, look at my face, I'm going to stand up. Whether you like it or not, I'm going to stand up because it's no longer I that I'm standing alone. I'm standing with my Jesus. So this morning, make it that day. Oh,
for us that are going through hard times, for us that are,
amen.
Going through situation, and you can be really down.
Hallelujah.
And your heart is not ready to receive any good news.
Yeah.
Your heart is not ready to accept something good to come your way. But
hallelujah.
I want to tell you, the Bible says, blessed are the pure,
hallelujah.
In heart, for they shall see God.
Amen.
You can see God in the situation that you have. What you have to do, just continue to hear the word of God. Continue to receive the word of,
hallelujah.
God.
Hallelujah.
And the word of God will come into your heart and cleanse your heart. Nothing else can,
amen.
Work in your heart. You need a dose from the word of God.
Hallelujah.
When you have the dose from the word of God, then you will trust in the word regardless of the situation,
hallelujah.
That is in front of you. You know, you can see, you can hear, you can feel the witness of the pandemic around you.
Amen.
You lost your job. There is no more money in the bank. Those are the realities of this life.
Hallelujah.
But remember, our God is as real as what we are,
hallelujah.
Going through right,
yes.
Now. He is so real. This God has already done it. I mean, if he can supply his manna for 40 years in the desert, he supplies water. He takes away enemies. Enemies after enemies that they face, the Amalekites, the Jebusites, the Canaanites, every enemies come their way, they were defeated. Why?
Hallelujah.
Because God was with them. Of course, the reality is out there. The reality, these people, they came from Egypt. They were not warriors.
Amen.
They were not soldiers. They were just a normal people.
Amen.
See what God can do in your situation,
hallelujah.
If you believe in God. So you must have a good heart in believing the word that we are sharing this morning. Every 10:30, God of our nation.
Hallelujah.
To encourage you to believe in the word of God. Because the word of God created the very thing that you have. The world that you are living in. The house that you have, the raw material of everything that you have comes from the word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So you need to believe in the word of God. The Bible says what is impossible with men is possible with God.
Hallelujah.
So that means whatever you're going through right now, the situation, the sickness, oh, I tell you, you have so many lists that you have. And maybe sometimes you don't want to listen to the word of God, because how can the word of God, how can the preaching, how can the teaching,
Amen.
How can the sharing come through the screen, deal with the situation that you have? No food in the fridge, no food in the cupboard.
Hallelujah.
But I want to tell you, the word of God that we are sharing today is so real than you, so real than the situation that you are facing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If the loaf of bread given, hallelujah, only two, can be divided to 5,000 men, excluding
Hallelujah.
Women and children. This is the thing that we need to believe. You don't have to calculate. You don't have to use your arithmetic. No, you just believe in the word of God.
Amen.
Because the word of God can do it. And you can do that because you have a clean heart. You have a good heart. And then God will work on your good heart because you are believing in his word. Or maybe you're facing a hard times in this
Hallelujah.
Life. We don't know the situation that you're going through. But when you have a good heart always call. It's like a magnet to the blessing. The blessing is already there. Remember, the curse too is already there. Then the condition of your heart will call whatever. You want to call curse? And then feel like that. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Be depressed.
Be bitter.
And bitter and anger and envy.
Oh, hallelujah.
Because the condition of your heart will call the blessing
yes.
or curses.
Yeah.
So we are sharing today, have a good heart. How can you have a good heart? Download the word of God into
Amen.
Your heart. Fill up your heart with the word of God. Because the Bible says, out of your heart comes the issues of life. So when you have a good heart, you are calling blessing. Don't look for blessing. Just check your heart.
Blessing will look Hallelujah. For you when your heart is good.
Yes, because the blessings are attracted to good heart.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's why we are focusing on good heart. In a time like this, when you can't turn anywhere, who to turn to at this
Hallelujah.
Time? You can turn to God by having a good heart. Just read through the word and hear the word. If you don't have the Bible or you can't read the word, remember, I already said 5 to 6 every morning, 8 to 9 every morning. The prayer at 11 o'clock, miracles do happen because it can happen to you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that's why we are standing here very confident.
Yes.
Very confident.
Try this, Jesus.
Yeah, because it's a testimony
Hallelujah.
After testimony.
Yes.
There are thousands of people that they are watching this program. Thousands of people. And there are a lot of testimonies after testimony. People that they don't belong to New Methodist or people they don't go to church at all. They are thinking. They are thinking now. They are deciding now to join the church. Hallelujah. Why? Because there is a power in the word of God. The whole universe was created by the
word
of
God.
Hallelujah. So we want to encourage you today before we go into Holy Communion.
Before we go into Holy Communion, wherever you are, in your family, the comfort of your home, or you may be in the hotel, or you may be in the car, you may be in your farm, wherever you are. You may not have the proper Holy Communion with you, but we will work with you today, and I will need you to come in agreement with us in whatever things that you're standing on. If you're with your family, this will be the time when you have Holy Communion to hold hands together
come
as a family.
Forward, yeah.
There are certain things that you have come in agreement together with your family or as a couple, things that you have written over the years, it
yes.
hasn't come to pass. Don't give up. This will be the time. Have hope in the hope of glory and the hope in Jesus.
Yes,
and for those of you that are standing on your own, just speak to God individually from your heart and believe in your heart that it can happen.
Amen.
So your list varies. Your list can differ from each other. It can be finances. It can be material things. It can be a spiritual life that you want to have a better relationship with God. It can be, you're asking God to take you to the right church or take you to a place that you can be nurtured in a spiritual walk with God. And if you already belong to a denomination, please continue.
continue to support your denomination and continue to support your pastors and continue to support the good work that has already been
Amen.
Done. So
Amen.
As you come and have Holy Communion, as well as what we have mentioned to in the earliest part of the program, that we will also remember those that has been sitting
yeah.
For the 18 individuals and families that have been coming here, not forgetting the Wanganivalu family all the way in Pennsylvania. We have other families. We have Var Hitchcock all the way in Sacramento. I thank you for those of you who do not belong to the church, but yet you've taken the time to seed and you've taken the time to be part of My TV in helping My TV continue to air this program, the Twist of Honor family.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of other families that I haven't mentioned this morning, but I would like to take this time to also remember you as we do Holy Communion and to pray, because whatever list that you have come in agreement with us today because of you sitting and activators, that it can come to pass. It can easily come to pass. Like what Twist of Honor shared with us this morning on the Viber, she was sitting. She's not a member of the church, lives all the way right up in England, and with her little son. She's the one who has been requesting from the beginning to pray for these 92 Iraq soldiers, because one of them is her dear brother. So it only took that, and she was sending across her tithe to headquarters and her giving and her sitting so solely that her brother can be healed. And because of that pledge, because of that plea, I saved the whole 92, because it became the focus yeah. of our prayer. It became the part of the program. It became the Holy Communion of healing. And by this morning, she provided that feedback that all are well and all back to work normal. So all of us today also will include Fiji as our nation to pray for, and wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to those in leadership, and also help those that are affected together with their families today.
Okay, we're preparing for Holy Communion. You can get your bread and you get your wine. Hallelujah. And we believe together, as we always said, the bread represents His body, and the wine represents His blood.
Amen.
So we will eat together, and we will drink together. So
Amen.
let us eat together.
Bread, fraction of the flesh.
Lord, we thank you for the bread. We thank you, Father God,
yes,
for
Father.
Representing your bread to your flesh today. And you said to the disciple, whenever you partake this,
Amen.
You must remember me. Father, we remember you this morning. And we remember all the things that you go through. We thank you for blessing our body, blessing
Amen.
Our organs. Thank you for healing for those that are sick. Wherever they are, we receive healing this morning. We receive healing to our body.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, He also poured out the wine and said, this is my blood represent. Hallelujah. And also, it's a new covenant. Let us drink together.
Lord, we stand on the promises of your word. We have partaken of, Father, the Holy Communion, having a covenant with you. We commit the things mentioned today, O Lord, for those that are sitting all over the world to send
yes.
us into My TV,
yes, Lord.
Investing into the program,
thank you, Lord.
As well as their time, their activators, and their sitting. Lord, we pray and we commit them unto your good
thank
hands.
Thank you, Jesus.
We remember them, Lord Jesus, this morning. Father, we also remember those that are sick. They have been writing their list for their healing. We continue to uphold them unto your victorious right hand, that you will completely heal them. Lord, we come in agreement for those that are writing their list. It can be the exam result for our children. It can be the broken home for our children. Praying for their mom and their dad to come back together. It can be, Lord Jesus, the heart's cry of a woman at home. Seeking your Lord Jesus and standing in faith that you will allow
Thank
her husband
Jesus.
To return.
Thank
and
you.
Also vice versa for the wife. Lord, we commit whatever situation that they are standing on today, their financial breakthrough, we pray and we also commit to their financial Lord Jesus, situation in every areas of their life. Father, we remember those that has been affected in Fiji on the COVID. We remember them, oh Lord Jesus, in the different places that they're in. We commit them unto your good hands. Oh. We stand on the promises of your word and the power of your blood. We receive healing into their body,
healing.
A strength of their hair to the sole of their feet. We receive your healing, Lord. We receive your blood covering, and we receive your seal of healing, Lord Jesus, into their lives, into their bodies, into their spirit, and into their soul. Father, we remember their families
yes,
that
Lord.
Are supporting them away from wherever they are.
Thank
we
you,
commit them unto your good hands, oh Father. Tamango kemenina marrena be matavale kemenina revira matavale tamango ratanya na bonyi kena singa erana numa tuna kalona non matavale ena be kamba ya de bir tamango sa lebe be kemenina matin tu bina kango viti ni bilu taki na nogo turang tamango me rongo ndondonga na damani. We pray and we commit, oh Father,
yes.
that you will anoint the president, you will anoint the prime minister and his family and all the families of those that are in leadership, the parliamentary lodge, the members of parliament, the opposition, and everything of our nation. We commit them to you. The frontliners, the Ministry of Health, the Ministry of Defense, so forth. We commit them all unto your good hands.
Yes.
Give them the strength, give them the knowledge, give them the know-how, give them the intelligence, so forth. Lord Jesus, for your name alone to be praised. Father, we also come before you today, and we commit our nation, Fiji. Father, we receive wisdom. We receive, oh Father, intelligence and knowledge into every citizen of Fiji. Tamango kimi sadingoma. Na yaluma tua, na vuko na kilaka, and na wimbula ndundua. Tamango mera yaluma tua taka na nonrambula. We receive, oh Father, that you will watch over our nation. You will never leave us. You will never forsake us. We stand today and we call on your goodness to overtake us in such a big way. Overtake our family, overtake the companies, overtake our nation, overtake in every area of our life. Your goodness to overtake us today. We commit all unto your good hands and we say we are grateful. We pray this prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen
and amen. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Thank you. My God of our nation.
Yes.
Until next week, remember 3 o'clock, we'll talk again live from here about tithing. Hallelujah.
Yes, 3 o'clock today, because of the current situation that we have, you will be hearing either we will be coming to the studio or replay program for today. So tune in again at 3 o'clock to 4:30 today, either on the Facebook page or on my TV for you to be part of enhancement, spiritual enhancement today. And the next week, we will be back at the same time, back at the studio at 10:30 on the God of Our Nation.
Yeah.
And whatever that you go through, don't limit yourself. Throughout the week, we will be having the miracles to happen. We always do. That is from 11 to 12. Yes, 11 to 12. If you do have a prayer request, please channel it through for our people to pray with you to bring that to pass. And those of you on Business House with ministry, we have a few business house that we always come to your companies on your invitation from Mondays to Friday with a lot of different companies involved. What we have done, because of the current situation that we have in the new norm, we will be having virtual business house. So whatever time that you are being scheduled to, on whichever day, we will also have that 1 to 2, but on virtual, which means for those of you that are logging in today or being part of hearing what we are announcing today, you can also join in. It's basically meant for the business house because of the schedule that we already have with them, but you can join in and also be part of that program. So 1 to 2 every day from Monday to Friday only.
Souls
to Jesus program. And also for the My TV, it's still going on as normal. And we pray, whatever it is that you're going through, grab as much word of God for you to hear. We have other churches coming in. We have other programs also flowing in through this platform in My TV. And we pray and we ask you, please tune in. We have the All Nation. We have the Triple C all the way in Osori. We have the Emmanuel. We have the Genesis to Revelation. There's a lot of denomination. Not only that, also for TV One, they have also church programs that are going. So it's not about the television stations. It's not about which company it is. It's about God. Please tune in and listen to the Word of God. Don't choose to hear or be selective to hear and only allow certain people to talk to you, or you belong to denomination. You don't leave yourself free and open to listen to others. Allow yourself to listen to every notation of the Word of God. Preach to you locally here in Fiji. So grab that. And we'll see you again next week at 10:30 on Sunday on the God of Our Nation.
God
bless you today.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Stop it na nende. Stop it na tabuto. Selenga wala ba? namagamay lima na kalogo na may mata katalaumana Radio Fiji kamasini ko Facebook Souls to Jesus rautalan ko sa rawa Daily Campus and my TV.